Hey guys, how you all doing today? Now for today's video, we've got some more news for Jurassic World Dominion, as Colin Trevorrow recently has done another interview where not only does he give some major information about some of the characters for the film, but has also revealed a new image that reveals Owen Grady and a new Parasaurolophus, which has led to an interesting story that should be starting the movie on a big twist. So not too long ago, Colin Trevorrow just did a new interview about the film Jurassic World Dominion, and with it came the release of the second official image for the film, which reveals Chris Pratt's Owen Grady dealing with a Parasaurolophus as he reaches towards it in a snowy environment, which already is just way, way crazy because we've never seen any dinosaurs apart from in Camp Cretaceous Season 4 in snow, and to see a Parasaurolophus of all of the creatures be in the snow, it's an amazing sight. And you hear me say Parasaurolophus, which is interesting because if we look at the Parasaurolophus's crest, at least the part that we can see, you can see that it is not the same as other Parasaurolophus crests we've seen in the past. Now, originally, a few months ago, an image came out that revealed this sort of Parasaurolophus, or Hadrosaur, and originally many people, myself included, believed it to be Kronosaurus, a fellow hadrosaur that was very similar to Parasaurolophus, but the only difference was the crest. As you can see here, it had a fleshy bit at the end, and this one does as well. However, in the interview, Colin Trevorrow confirms that this image is actually of a Parasaurolophus with Owen Grady, as he explains what the scene is, which we'll go into in a little bit, but it is really interesting to see that already this is a new version of a dinosaur, which, since it is confirmed to be a Parasaurolophus from Jurassic World, could it be a sexual dimorphism? After all, we've only seen the male versions of the Parasaurolophus in Jurassic World, which we had also seen in The Lost World, and we haven't really seen the versions that were from Jurassic Park in a long time, so it is interesting to see. We don't know where this Parasaurolophus came from, but maybe it's just another version, like a different sex, which, interestingly enough, looking back on the franchise, I think the only other dinosaur we've seen for herbivores that has had sexual dimorphism that is clearly showing difference is in the recent Nasutoceratops from Battle at Big Rock, as you can clearly see the horns are different on the males compared to the females. But other than that, the only sexual dimorphism we've seen for dinosaurs has been with the carnivores, mainly with the T-Rexes and the Velociraptors. But it's nice to see another herbivore have sexual dimorphism. But this is just the minor stuff, because in the interview, Colin Trevorrow explains a lot about what this image implies, because it's going to be part of the opening of the movie, and also explains some interesting things about Bryce Dallas Howard's Claire Dearing and Owen Grady, as well as the original trio of characters, as well as some information about Lewis Dotson, which we're going to go all over all by first reading the article and what he said. Jurassic World Dominion, the sixth entry in the Jurassic Park franchise, takes place 4 years after 2018's Fallen Kingdom, enough time for dinosaurs to have found a way to spread around the globe. They have been multiplying and living amongst us and clashing with us, says the filmmaker and co-writer Colin Trevorrow, who directed 2015's Jurassic World and Battle at Big Rock. The other Jurassic Park movies pretty much have the same story, he says, but Dominion is set all over the world, throughout many different environments, wilderness, urban, desert, snow. It's exciting to see these creatures navigate environments that they weren't built to survive in. They grew up in a theme park, and now they're here. At the start of the film, out in June 10th, Bryce Dallas Howard's Claire Dearing and Chris Pratt's Owen Grady are still attempting to save the big beast, with the latter rounding up Parasaurolophus in the Sierra Nevadas. He's not too far from where the dinosaurs got out in the last film, says Trevorrow. The parasaurs are in danger of being poached. There is a lot of shady types who want to get their hands on dinosaurs, so he's working to protect them. Trevorrow continues on with the story as he mentions about Claire's character. Trevorrow is cagier about where we find Claire. I don't want to say just yet, he explains, but she's at a point where she's questioning her methods and whether she can stay safe and fulfill the responsibility that she has to other people in her life that she cares about. and that care about her. Arguably even bigger news than the widespread dinosaurs decimation, the return of Sam Neill, Laura Dern, and Jeff Goldblum reunited on the screen for the first time since Steven Spielberg's adaptation of Michael Crichton's novel Jurassic Park back in 1993. And the director mentions that they won't be in a cameo appearance just like Jeff Goldblum was in Fallen Kingdom. They have equal screen time to Bryce and Chris, Trevorrow reveals for the scientist trio. They are major characters from start to finish, and the director describes Dominion as more of a scientific thriller than a horror-flavored J.A. Bayona-directed Fallen Kingdom, and strongly hints that the movie's big bad will be Campbell Scott's Lewis Dodson. He is the main villain throughout both of Crichton's novels, and I think what Campbell's done with the character is just amazing, he says, and I can't wait for people to see it. And also it goes on to mention a few other things, but the interesting thing is what they've shown about Claire, most importantly for me. Like, they mention about how Bryce Dallas Howard's Claire Dearing is going to be in a sort of struggle with her feelings and stuff, which is interesting to see and a really good thing, because one thing I was personally worried about with the film was whether or not they were going to continue Claire's story, because realistically for the Jurassic World films, the main story that we are following for humans is Claire's story, and I was worried that with the inclusion of Alan Grant, Ellie Sattler, and Ian Malcolm along with the other main characters, I was worried that her story was going to be sort of left to the side, but it looks like from what Colin Trevorrow has stated that she will be the main part of the story still, which is really good to hear. And it's interesting to hear that she is now questioning whether what she did in Fallen Kingdom was the right choice. After all, the scene that this image is implying is that they are protecting these dinosaurs from poachers, which honestly, she's probably questioning whether it was better to just let them die on Isla Nublar and let their suffering end. Or just, which, did she make the right call? And that's a really good thing to see. I'm really glad that they're making her question herself because, well, for a lot of people, she did the right thing and others, she did the wrong thing. It's really interesting to see the character who made the choice herself be questioning whether she did the right thing or not. And it's really going to be interesting when she clashes with Ian Malcolm. After all, he is completely opposite to her. He has always been against the dinosaurs, and while he doesn't think that they deserve all the suffering they get, he does think that humans need to be protected from themselves, and I don't think he would agree with her methods in bringing it. But it's going to be interesting. After all, as Eli Mills said, they can't bring it, put it back in the box. Dinosaurs are now all over the world, and they are causing chaos wherever they go, and are being hunted down by poachers, it seems. And Colin Trevorrow going over Lewis Dodson and how Campbell Scott has made him very interesting and he can't wait for us to see it. That's going to be really interesting, especially considering that this is a new actor playing him from who played him, because the original actor, well, did some terrible things in real life, which we won't talk about here. And I honestly can't wait for this film, guys. Like, the fact that we've already gotten two official images and, like, so much explanation for them, and the fact that simply they're just telling us that, like, Claire is basically going through another struggle. Like, the first movie, I think that Claire's story is probably one of the best in the franchise, even though I know a lot of people don't really like the new trilogy's characters and stuff. I actually think she's one of our better characters, especially because of how expansive her story is. Like, in the first movie, she was a businesswoman simply, but then realizing her mistakes and realizing that the dinosaurs deserve to be free and live, Fallen Kingdom shows her admiring her, changing herself, and now realizing that she needs to protect these dinosaurs. And now that we're going to see that maybe she's questioning whether what she did for the dinosaurs and saving them from Nublar was the right thing, because now they're all over the world and also being hunted by people who care nothing for them. It's really interesting, and I'm really glad to see that they are staying with her story. But one thing that's really interesting that we haven't heard, that this is just me, but we haven't heard anything about any of the other major characters, like Maisie, for example. We haven't heard anything about what her story is going to be, and I hope they don't, like, sideline her too much either, especially because, after all, her story was she's the first human clone in history, so that's got to have some major importance in some ways, which can't wait to see what that could be for this film. Who knows? But anyway, guys, what do you think about this little bit of news that we got? A little small bit of news from the previous image that we got of the Therizinosaurus and Claire, as before. But it's really good to see that we're getting more for Claire, more for the main characters, and also for Lewis Dodson. And even Owen is getting a change in his character, as he is actually defending these dinosaurs too, unlike how he was in Fallen Kingdom, which is interesting, I might add. But what do you guys think? Do you like how they're keeping Claire's story as the main focus, like they did for the previous films? Or do you wish that it was more on the side? And what do you think about this new Parasaurolophus design? Do you think it's going to be revealed as, like, a different Parasaurolophus entirely? Do you think it's going to be a different gender or something, sexual dimorphism? Or do you think they're just redesigning it for the sake of redesigning it? Whatever your own thoughts and opinions happen to be, I'd love to hear them all in the comments down below. And if you've enjoyed this video, guys, I would appreciate the like. And if you haven't already, do hit the subscribe button to join the hunt. Be safe, and until next time, guys, I'll see you later. Bye-bye!